Hello friends, I am Dr. Saurabh Patwardhan and in this video I'll be speaking about the weight lab training for CCC. Most important thing before you start the weight lab is to know the theory behind the capsulorhexis, to know the shearing force where you go along the tear and ripping force where you go perpendicular to it. So you have to understand these two movements and these two movements are used for doing the capsulorhexis. So know your theory well before you start. Now even without weight lab you can practice capsulorhexis on microwaved tomato skin, and you can see how you can peel it just like capsulorhexis. You can also use onion. So this is called kitchen lab. This is a nice video by Dr. John Davis and his colleagues. Apart from these, there are many things available, including the skills lab, the simulators, the augmented reality, and also 3D printed models are there to help you in training in psychomotor skills. Goat size and pig size can also be used, though they give a good feel, but it's not similar to human eyes, but it's a good alternative to human eyes. What we use in our setup is the Kitaro dry lab and wet lab, which is very useful for beginners to learn the skills, learn the movements which are to be used during the different steps of the surgery. So this is the dry lab setup, which on the clay a gelatin paper is placed, and over that there is a acrylic cap which has pre-prepared holes in it for the side port incision, and through it you can go with the cystitome and try to mimic the same movements which you are going to use during the surgery. Use the shearing force, use the ripping force, and try to make capsulorhexis of good size. You can also use the forceps for doing capsulorhexis, and this doesn't require even microscope, so you can use it anytime that you like. You don't need any surgical setup for doing this, and your hands and eyes are trained for the movements of your instruments with this dry lab. And the advantage of this is that you can also practice some maneuvers mimicking, there is extension of capsulorhexis and how you will take it back or how you will make another nick, and you can practice as many as you want. You can use the same in wet lab, where actual operation setup is there, where you can sit on the microscope, put the foot switch in, and use the artificial eye which has a silicone cornea over it, and through the side port incision you can introduce the cystitome, you can introduce OVD over the capsule and start doing capsulorhexis. Here the trainer can train you in how to keep the flap flat on the anterior surface of the lens, which is very important while doing. Also how to stabilize the eye during the surgery. You can use either a Sinsky dialer or you can use limbs forceps to hold the eye during the movements. Also you have to use your foot switch to focus continuously, also center the eye, which you can do during this wet lab session. This mimics the actual surgery. You can also use different instruments like forceps, microcapsular forceps, or cystitome during this wet lab session. So you can use your hands, your foot switch to control the microscope to focus and align. You have to keep repeatedly doing it so that you become better with your hand-eye coordination and you can do well with the capsulorhexis in human eyes. There are many videos on the YouTube, you can go through them. They are excellent videos for learning how to use the wet lab. Thank you.